Hello, fifth grade. This movie is going to show you how to use two student-friendly search engines to find more information on your scientist. You'll begin at the HP Rader Library Student Resources page, and your search engine links are down here. We're going to use SweetSearch and SearchyPants. Both are Google searches, but they are customized searches to be more student-friendly. For SweetSearch, you get your typical search box. Don't forget to search inside quotation marks. And you get your results page. You get a link to the site as well as a snapshot of the site with your search terms highlighted. To preview the site, you can click on one of the snapshots and get a quick preview of this website to see if you want to use it. You can close the preview pane and visit the exact site by right-clicking, opening in a new tab so that you have access to your website as well as the results if you need to come back. Now that you've determined it's a site you want to use, you need to cite your source. In Noodle Tools, you can do it two ways. You can cite it by simply grabbing the URL, copy, and then paste it in the Quick Cite section. Don't forget to tell it that you're going to cite a website. You can skip the tutorial, and there's your Quick Cite button. And paste here where it says manually edited. That's the fast way, and this is totally fine to do it this way. If you want to have a more clear URL, I'm sorry, citation, you'll want to put in a little more information. This is the one that we just did, and this is all you get. If you want it to be a little more descriptive, you add a few more pieces of information by citing in a slightly different way. You will again start at the citation area. I'm citing a website. And again, you'll skip the tutorial. But instead of using the Quick Cite, this time we're going to fill in a couple of fields. This is where you would put the URL. And then it wants to know the name of the site. So you simply navigate back to the site and look way at the top. And the title of the site is going to be right there, way at the top. And it normally will show on every single page that you visit within the site. If you were to change links within the site, Nobelprize.org still shows so that you know that's the title of your site. So you go right here and you type in Nobelprize.org. And then you submit. And now you have a little bit more of a description of the site that you used. SearchyPants will work slightly differently because you have to create the pants first. So right here where it says Change Me, you normally can type your teacher's name and then create the pants. But if that is not working, then you can also put it up in the URL. Do you see how it has slash col up here? If it wouldn't let you create the pants below, then you just type in your teacher's last name at the end of the URL and it will let you create the pants and search. When you search in SearchyPants, again, I would do my search inside quotations, and you get your results. Now, this looks more like a typical Google search. It will have ads at the top and off to the side. Ignore the ads. Go just to the areas where it has links to the information that you want. So if you want to open this link, again, right-click, open it in a new tab. And if you want to use this website, then you would cite the source first. Remember, you have the two options to do a quick cite, or you can go the longer route and put the name of the website as well as the URL. I want to show you one little tip to help you find information inside a website. If you're looking for something specific, you can use a Control F on your keyboard, and you'll get a little search box that comes up at the top. You can type in the topic of the information you're looking for. Let's say you want more information on his family. You type in your search term up here, and you can see I've got 1 out of 10 results. And I just scroll through my results by going right here to these arrows, and it will highlight your results each time. So there's information about the family again, and I just scroll through. When I realize all the areas of information, I can read it, cite it, and print it. And remember, the best way to print from websites is by using the highlight and selection method. Good luck finding the rest of the information for your project.